Hello everyone, I welcome you once again to OEM Learning, and in this geography video we will be learning the third chapter of standard 10, that is water resources. Student, here are few facts and figures regarding the water resource. See, 96.5% of the total volume of world's water is estimated to exist as oceans and only 2.5% as fresh water. Nearly 70% of this fresh water occurs as ice sheets and glaciers in Antarctica, Greenland, mountainous regions of the world, while a little less than 30% is stored as groundwater in the world's aquifers. India receives nearly 4% of the global precipitation and ranks 133 in the world in terms of water availability as person per annum. Okay, so like we are on 133 rank in terms of water availability per person per annum. The total renewable water resources of India are estimated at 1897 square kilometer per annum. By 2025, it is predicted that large parts of India will join countries or regions having absolute water scarcity. See, what do we mean by water scarcity? The availability of water resources varies from space and time. Here, space means the geographical area and time. The water scarcity is caused by over-exploitation, excessive use, and unequal access to water among different social groups. Water resources are being over-exploited to expand irrigated areas for dry season agriculture. In some areas, water is sufficiently available to meet the needs of the people, but those areas still suffer from water scarcity due to bad quality of water. Water stress. This is a term which is nowadays very much being in the news and the newspaper also. Water stress. Water stress means that occurs when water availability is less than 1000 cubic meter per person per day. It means that water is so scarce, so much in scarcity that we are not able to fulfill the minimum requirement of 1000 cubic meter per person per day. India's rivers, especially the smaller ones, have all turned into toxic streams. And even the big ones like the Ganga and Yamuna are far from being pure. The assault on India's rivers from population growth, agricultural modernization, urbanization, and industrialization is enormous and growing day by day. So this entire life stands threatened. And we all know that our Earth is called as a blue planet because of water only. And how much important water is for our life and existence. These are again few facts that 50% of India faces high to extreme high water stresses. This is an India map where you can see that how the colors with yellow, red and orange in extreme areas are being shown with arid and low water uses, and high use, then extremely high uses, okay, low to medium uses. So it is diversified way to show that how water is also a scarce resource for all of us. Okay, then Indian water crisis, like it is 600 million Indians face high to extreme stress over water. These pictures are not new to us. It's already there in the news. I hope all of you have already seen such kind of pictures. This is the picture that I have taken from the few of the areas in Maharashtra. You can see the soil. It is your black soil that develops cracks in summer season when there is no water. Okay. So, why we need to conserve water and how can we manage the water? We need to conserve water so that we can safeguard ourselves from health hazards. We can ensure food security, continuation of our livelihoods and productive activities. This will also prevent degradation of our natural ecosystems, and over-exploitation and mismanagement of water resources will impoverish this resource and cause ecological crisis. So in order to overcome all these problems, we need to conserve water. Now, how can we manage the water? See, these are a few hydraulic structures in ancient India. Okay, so conserving water is not a new concept. It has been with us from the long years, and from the ancient times only we have many structure that is there even today that can be found and that can be visited, and that proves that how water is necessary and why we need to conserve it to that much of extent. See, here few examples are given. Like in the 1st century BC, Sri Ranga Virupura near Allahabad had sophisticated water harvesting system, channeling the flood water of the river Ganga. Then during the time of Chandragupta Maurya, dams, lakes and irrigation systems were extensively built. Then there are evidences of sophisticated irrigation works have also been found in Kalinga, that is Odisha, the Nagarjunakonda, Andhra Pradesh, Bennur, Karnataka, Kolhapur, Maharashtra, etc. Then in the 11th century Bhopal Lake, one of the largest artificial lakes of its time, was built. Then in the 14th century, the tank in Hoj Khas, Delhi, was constructed by Iltutmish for supplying water to Siri Fort area. So you're conserving water, whether it may be in a way of making a dam or to make a lake or to have some irrigation system, has been there with us from the ancient times. Though this picture is not very much clear, but I could arrange this one only, that shows few of the ways of conserving water. Like if you see in the very in the northern part of India, the picture is of Kuli, that is Kuli in Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh. This is a system of conserving water where what happens is a pond like structure is being created, and then water from the glaciers or water from the nearby rivers are being collected there that can be used further for other purposes of water use. Then there is a picture from Nagaland. There is written Zabo, again a way to conserve water. Then Arhar peonies in Bihar. Then your picture of bamboo or drip irrigation system from Meghalaya. Then we have Iri, Tamil Nadu. Okay, it is one of the ancient ways of conserving water. Then we have Surangam, okay, Kerala and Karnataka. You're like, it's like making a tunnel, okay, through which you're trying to collect the water and saving it for the future use. Then we have Virdas in Gujarat and Kundi or Kundas in Rajasthan, even Johats in Rajasthan. These are the few names and traditional way of conserving water. And now we will be discussing about your multi-purpose river projects and integrated water resource management. See, in ancient time, we used to conserve water by constructing sophisticated hydraulic structures like dams built of stone rubble, reservoirs or lakes, embankments and canals for irrigation. We have continued this tradition in modern India by building dams in most of our river basins. Multi-purpose river valley projects are basically designed for the development of irrigation for agriculture and electricity through the construction of dams. Initially, dams were built only for storing rainwater to prevent flooding, but now it became multi-purpose. Now, in multi-purpose, what we are trying to do, how we are trying to use water, the stored water in various ways, that the water that is being collected to store it for the future use, the retaining water can be used through canals for irrigation. Okay, water can be processed and then pipelines to can be attached to supply water to cities, and it can also be used to generate power. So these often include transportation, improvements and industrial growth. They are also developed to reduce the dangers of flooding. Some of the multi-purpose projects in India are Bhakra Nangal Project, Hirakud Dam Project, Mayurakshi Project, Damodar Valley Project, Sardar Sarovar Project, Western Yamuna Canal, then Eastern Yamuna Canal and Periyar Vargi Projects. See, students, here I would like to remind you that this chapter this chapter will be evaluated mostly in your periodic test, but the map work as per the CBSE syllabus will be coming in your board example. The theory part will not be asked in the board, but your map work or map skill from this chapter will be asked in your board examination. So you have to learn and the location of all these dams and multipurpose projects and even some of the Indian rivers. Now, what are the advantages of multipurpose projects? See, it controls floods, it provides irrigation facility and navigation, it helps in generating electricity, it promotes inland irrigation, fishing and afforestation, and this strengthens the livelihood of the people around. Then it is used for human consumption and it provides your power generation. Then all everything which has an advantage, it also have some disadvantage also. So when we talk about disadvantages of multipurpose project, it is like it induces earthquake. Now how it is possible? See, your water has a weight also and it has force also. So when we are storing a large amount of quantity of water, okay, in one place, so it can induce earthquakes due to its force. Then population get displaced. When we are making a dam, the people around that area that we are choosing to prepare a dam or build a dam needs to be displaced. Okay, so displacement of population, it is not a very easy thing. Even if we are displacing this entire community from the nearby areas, we need to take care of their rehabilitation. So it's a disadvantage on parts of the local tribes or local people. Then even aquatic life gets affected. The flow of underground water is also checked. Then river water gets diverted. Extensive forest submerged under water because of the construction of the dam. And there are chances that few people even lost their livelihood because of construction of the dam. Then there would be loss of natural biodiversity. Then there would be increase in evaporation. Greenhouse gas emission will be there. Then there are chances that if there are some historical and archaeological sites in the area, it can also be destroyed. So these are the few disadvantages of multipurpose projects. Now we will talk about dams. A dam is a barrier across flowing water that obstructs, directs or retards the flow, often creating a reservoir, lake or impoundment. Dam refers to the reservoir rather than the structure. So it's just a barrier, okay, that obstructs the flow of water. And then what we do, we will be able to reserve or create a reservoir for water conservation. What are the uses of dams? Dams are built to impound rivers and rainwater that can be used later to irrigate agricultural fields. Then through the dam, we can generate electricity, water supply for domestic and industrial uses. It can control the flood and then also recreation and inland navigation as well as fish breeding. Then what are the side effects of creating dams? Regulating and damming of rivers affect the natural flow of the water body. Then poor are the habitats for the river's aquatic life. Fragment rivers make it difficult for aquatic fauna to migrate. Then dams created on the floodplain submerge the existing vegetation and soil, leading to its decomposition over a period of time. Then also, creating of large dams has been the cause of many new environmental movements like the Narmada Bachao Andolan and the Tehri Dam Andolan, etc. Then many times local people had to give up their land, livelihood and their control over resources for the construction of the dam. So as I was saying about displacing local people and then talking about the rehabilitation is not that easy. So as I was speaking about your map skill from this chapter, this one is of major importance and I want you to please look into this map. And these are the dams that is being given as per the CBSE syllabus to be asked. Salal project, I hope you can identify a Salal project as in Jammu Kashmir. Then Tehri Dam. Okay, then Rana Pratap Sagar in Rajasthan, then Sardar Sarovar in Maharashtra, then Hirakud in Odisha, Nagarjun Sagar in your Karnataka, then Tugbhadra, okay, in Karnataka. So, Tehri in your Uttaranchal, okay. So, see, these are the major dams that you should, repeatedly you should identify it and you should learn how to plot these dams on a map. See, your Nagarjun Sagar will be in your Andhra Pradesh. Okay. So now we will talk about rainwater harvesting. Rainwater harvesting is a simple method by which rainfall is collected for future usage. The collected rainwater may be stored, utilized in different ways, or directly used for recharge purposes. See from the picture, I hope you can identify how your rainwater is being collected from the collection area, that is being passed on through the pipelines to the collection area. Then we can attach a storage tank, and with the use of some filters, that can the water can be filtered and then used through the taps. We can also directly put the water to the underground recharge facility, and that can also be reused through the pipelines and the tap. Other different methods have been adopted in different areas, like in hills and mountain regions. People build the diversion channels like the Ghuls and Kuls of the Western Himalayas for agriculture. Then rooftop rainwater harvesting is commonly practiced to store drinking water, particularly in Rajasthan. In the floodplains of Bengal, people developed inundation channels to irrigate their fields. Then in arid and semi-arid regions, agricultural fields were converted into rain-fed storage structures that allowed the water to stand and moisten in the soil, such as Khadins in Jaisalmer and Johats in other parts of Rajasthan. The tankas are part of the well-developed rooftop rainwater harvesting system and are built inside the main house or the courtyard. This is mainly practiced in Rajasthan, particularly in Bikaner, Phalodi, Barmer areas for saving the rainwater. Many houses constructed underground rooms adjoining to tanka to beat the summer heat, as it could keep the room cool. See these posters saying conserve water, save the planet. Then your poster to save water and you do not know it's true worth until it's gone. Then how you can be a water harvester when you collect the monsoon water. Thank you and have a happy learning. I hope again this chapter would be clear to you. I also like you to refer to all the your study materials and your textbook particularly, so that you will have better understanding of the chapter. And I will like to repeat also that this chapter, according to CBSE syllabus, theoretically will be evaluated in your periodic test, whereas the map skill of this chapter will be coming in your board examination. So please you practice the map as I was explaining in your video, particularly your dams and some of the rivers. Thank you once again to all of you. Have a good time.